Hello friends, here we are again back with our next recap. It's recap number 6 and recap 6. Okay, now in this recap we are going to study about fourth property. We are undergoing properties. We are learning these days properties of the whole numbers, and till now we have done three of the properties. The very first property is the closure property. We have already done closure property, okay, and then the second property which we have already done is commutative property, okay. And the third property which we have done, it is related to associative property, okay. And now the fourth property which we are going to do is about, it is the fourth property and it is known as distributive property. What do we say? Distributive property. But its full name is distributive property of multiplication over addition. Now what is there in this? First of all, you have to understand that these two properties are related to any of the numbers, but in this case the associative property is applicable for more than two numbers, right? This associative property is applicable for more than two numbers, because we need grouping. In this case we are doing grouping, or we are doing associations, okay, or we are making groups of numbers. Similarly, in this case also the property is applicable for more than two numbers, okay. This property is applicable for more than two numbers, okay. So for more than two numbers, okay. Now if we are going to take, suppose what this property states, that we are going to understand now. So if A, B and C, if these three numbers are there and they are taken from whole numbers family, they belong to whole numbers. When I'm saying belong to, this is a symbol of belong to, okay. And when I'm saying belong to, it means I'm taking three numbers out of whole numbers, okay. Now A, B, C, they are three numbers and they are from whole numbers family. In such a in such case distributive property, how it is applying on this, we are going to understand that if A is there, A is multiplied with A into B plus C, it can be written as, what it states, it can be written as A into B. That means, this means what? That this A is, the first number is multiplied with the very first number, and also it is multiplying with the second number as well. It means A is multiplied with B as well as A is multiplied with C. What is happening here? That A is multiplied, out of these three numbers, if one number is multiplied with both numbers, so we can add, and also they are added, if one number is multiplied with both numbers, so we say that distributive property of multiplication, this is multiplication which is going on. Multiplication is done with B also, multiplication is done with C also, and both are added also. In such a case we say that distributive property of multiplication over addition. Okay, that is why the name is here. Now what it states, what it is going to be equal to, when we are going to split, actually what is happening here, this A is multiplying to B as well as this A is multiplying to C, okay. That is why we are getting here two groups. You can see there are two groups, A is multiplied with B as well as A is multiplied with C. Okay, now you have to remember that when we are going to do the problems on the basis of distributivity, just remember that we can either, the question is given in this form. If the question is given in this form, in LHS, suppose this is LHS, okay, and suppose this is RHS. We know that if equal to sign is in between, then the left hand side is known as LHS and the right hand side of the equal to sign is known as RHS, okay. Now if the question is given in this form, you have to change it to this form, Okay, if LHS is provided to you in question form, then when you are going to apply distributive property, then you will change LHS to a right hand side form. Okay, and if the question format is given to you in this form, then you are simply going to change it to this form. This is only there in the distributive property while doing the calculations or while doing your questions, solving the questions. Okay. So this is how properties are there in the case of whole numbers, integer. Even this property is applicable in all the cases, whole numbers, integers, rational numbers. So you are very much now known with these properties, and I hope you are going to understand all these, and when we are going to do the solutions or the questions, you will be able to find the solutions easily. Okay. Let us take one example here. Okay, I'm taking one example for each of these properties. Okay, this is not required because it is only to understand that a property is going to be from this states that if you are taking from one family or one group of collection of numbers, then the result also after operations, after mathematical operations, the result will be also from the same group of family. Okay, so we are not going to do this, but yes, commutative, associative and distributive property, we will be dealing one questions from each in the next recap. Okay, thank you.